There is so much to see in April that we decided to do another day in April. We first have a look at our epiphytic cacti. We do love the colorful Rhipsalis species. We like the way that the flowers of Rhipsalis ruri break out of the stems. But also other species, including some hybrids, are very nice and give a lot of flowers. We do not have many Mexican species anymore, but what we have, we like. I think we keep them for a while. This Trombocactus disciformis was seedling in 1990, so it's over 25 years old at the moment. Let's turn over to the unwarmed greenhouses, where it's getting cold in winter. Last episode we said already, we have a lot of work to do and we are just getting started with it. Lucky enough, we have some helpers, so we can spend our time just looking at the plants. The fruits of Escobaria missouriensis are good visible now. The flowering of Pediococcus paradinae is almost over, and the scleral cacti take over at the moment. All these Echinus aureus ventralis look very promising at the moment. When you put some Sclerocactus mesoverde together, you can get a nice display. Echinus aureus viridiflorus flowers already as a small plant. We do have some Gymnocalycium, but not very many species. As we said, Sclerocactus time at the moment. Many species flowering. One with very nice colorful flowers. One of our favorites. Also, Tomea papyracantha is starting to flower at the moment. This here is a crossing between Tomea papyracantha and a sclero, combining both species to the best. We hope you like this episode as much as we do. And don't forget to subscribe so you will get a message when there's a next episode, which will be May, I guess. Thank you for watching.